coming to the left of Giguere. Leafs are able to poke it free at center. Tim Brent onto the right wing side. And Clark MacArthur decided not to give the puck away, tried to hang on to it. And an interference call coming to New York. Mark Stahl.
And right down the boards here. Yep. That's the right call.
2:48, the time of the penalty for interference to Stahl. The Leafs with their seventh power play opportunity with 2:12 left to go in the overtime. 4-on-3. And that wasn't done correctly. Well, they'll do it all over again. Some of the goaltenders that Carberlet has scored on: Brodeur, Fleury twice, Marty Biron. His first overtime winner in Montreal against Jeff Hackett. He's out there again. Back of the net is Bozak. Bozak to Carberlet. Carberlet holds the puck, trying to stretch things out. Bozak with Phaneuf off to the side. Down low it goes. Here's a shot from the charge side. Scores! Phil Kessel wins the game in overtime for Toronto. Their fourth in a row.
And this time, it's Dion Phaneuf who's in front of the net that creates the screen. And with good traffic, that's what they had to do to get this win, as Lundqvist has been so hot. But Phaneuf, there he goes, right to the middle of the net, and screens the goaltender, and Lundqvist has no look at that shot at all for Kessel, who just shows wonderful patience and throws it right up into the roof.
So, fans, and thanks to that Toronto power play goal, Anthony Castrol will be entered into the draw to receive the live call on the last Toronto Sportsnet game of the season.